Hey guys, Andrew here, also known as SlayerRocker36, and today we are going to be talking about Minecraft 1.7 news and all that stuff. Now real quick, before I start, we are doing a special giveaway in this video. To make up for some bad news, we are giving away one Minecraft premium account gift code or anything on the Minecraft Jinx store under $30. If you want a chance to win, just leave a comment in the comment section below telling us what you guys think about the 1.7 update out of everything that we know of now. Leave a comment below, I look forward to reading your response, and if you do win, I will message you here on YouTube, so make sure to check your YouTube inbox messages. And if you could leave a like, that would also mean a lot. If we get more than 1,000 likes, then we will do something epic as a surprise. But let's get started with the news. So this week is the 35th week of 2013, and because of that, today's snapshot was supposed to be 13w35a. Now I am making this video to not just inform you guys on the good and the bad news, but to basically run through everything real quick, because there's a lot of news so far. So snapshot 13w35a, as the making of this video, the 29th Thursday, DinnerBone stated, and by the way, he left home sick early today from Mojang. He was not feeling so well. He was tweeting all day about that. But yeah, there is no snapshot today. He confirmed it when someone asked him, is there a snapshot today? And he said, no, sorry. That does not mean there won't be a snapshot this week, though. Now, we're not saying that it'll be here tomorrow. Now, in the past, it's almost always on a Thursday. If not on a Thursday, it's on a Friday, and very rarely they release it on a Wednesday. So, you know, we might still get the snapshot tomorrow. Now, the reason why there might not be a chance of it coming out tomorrow is because Mojang is having a special event in London, I believe. It's an art thing, and Jeb's probably going to be there, I believe. And because of that, that makes us think that there won't be a snapshot because they're going to be out of the office. Or, that could actually be a reason why they might be waiting today so that they release it tomorrow, and at the art gallery, they're like, we also have these awesome biomes and it just came out. I don't know, that's just a theory, but most likely it will come out next week. I can 100% guarantee you this time that it definitely will be out next week, because it's just been way too long. We know for a fact that they have stuff getting ready, and we know that everyone is getting anxious, and it's going to be to the same point where if they don't release a snapshot, everyone's just going to get bored and it's not going to be good. So, or it's going to be a great update, don't get me wrong, but you know, the community is going to get like, oh, so saturated, people just stop getting interested in it. Plus, everyone is going back to school now. Now, I already graduated, but I'm getting that from a lot of people right now, and that's, I don't know how I feel about that. I don't know if that's really gonna affect it negatively, but a lot of people are going back to school now, and they may be waiting every single day looking on their phones when the update is coming out, and with it not coming out, it's kind of like a bum. But I don't know, let's talk about the news though, because they did release a lot of news today. I also want to announce some awesome things about Minecon 2013. Now, if you guys know King Jojo, MVG, all the guys, well, there's a bunch of stuff. I don't want to talk too much about it, but there are a lot of awesome YouTubers that are going to be a part of it. I know you guys know Beatbop Vox and Aviator Gaming, and some of the guys are going to be part of some awesome stuff at a booth at Minecon 2013. So if you guys are going to be there, we're going to be doing a lot of awesome special stuff. You can get signings with all of the guys, including ourselves, and there's going to be a bunch of epic things, which we will talk about later. But if you will be at Minecon 2013, we will be doing a bunch of epic stuff there, giving away a ton of really cool stuff. And also, we will be doing a couple live shows there, and we will be uploading those to YouTube for the people that are not there. You at least won't miss out, and we'll make sure to make it feel like if you were there. So that was it for that. Let's talk about the news that came out today though, which I kind of talked about earlier, but it actually got updated. So let's talk about the stuff from Jeb. This actually hasn't changed as the making of this video, but it is news nonetheless. If you guys remember yesterday's video, he actually put out a vlog post on the Mojang website about the new biomes. He had a big picture, an overview of the 1.6 and beyond, or not beyond, before biomes, and you could see how spaced out they were. And then he released one today, or actually no, yesterday, then he released another one of 1.7, and you could see there's so many more biomes, they're really close, and you could also see many islands all around the oceans. Now he was getting a lot of complaints from people saying that the oceans now were not as big and large and bare, and they're filled with islands and all that stuff. So after a while he decided, and that's what he released today, that he removed a lot of the mini islands, which in my personal opinion, which this doesn't, you know, this is not your guys' opinion, this is mine, I'm actually kind of disappointed because I really like the idea of islands. Just, I don't know, I hate the look of that. Or actually, there's no oceans here, but I thought there was an ocean behind me or in front of me, but the oceans are just boring, and unless if they have like whales or some type of awesome feature that makes it so that the oceans are cool again, unless if they add that, there's no point of giant oceans. I mean, everyone is traveling by horse now, and you can't really do anything over water besides push your horse across with a lead or something. So I don't know, I think it would be really cool if they added mini islands, made that like its own cool biome, added some special features to it, but I don't know, I miss the fact, well, tell me what you guys think. I want to see your opinions. Did you guys prefer mini islands or not? And see, this is why I wish they would have released a snapshot. I don't know why they haven't released it, either the biomes just aren't ready, but I mean, the snapshot is for testing, but you know, currently just the whole entire culture of the snapshots, it's basically like getting the updates early, and everyone will judge the snapshots as an update itself. So I'm pretty sure that's the main reason why Jeb hasn't released it yet. He doesn't want people to start hating on it, or it's just not ready, one of the two. But because of that, you know, I really want to see, or at least I want to test it out for myself, how many islands would work. But I don't know, that's just the news for that. In other news, DinnerBone updated himself or his tweets about the new sliders for the volume in Minecraft. And what it basically is he added more sliders to music and sound options menu for Minecraft 1.7. Now, I talked about this in the earlier video today, but he updated even more and added more things. So all the things that you can now control, there's the master volume to turn your volume from 0% to 100. Then there's individual ones, and the individual ones are music, weather, enemy monsters, players, jukebox slash note blocks, block slash environment, and friendly animals. So you can control all of that. You can turn like hostile mobs or enemy monsters down while keeping friendly animals up. And I don't know, I think it'd be pretty cool, especially if you live, let's say you're next to like a mob grinder and you don't want to be hearing mobs all the time. You can lower that volume, or for let's plays or really anything. I think this is going to be awesome. And other good news, Mojang was actually on Edge Magazine. They were talking about that, tweeting about it this morning, so that's just some awesome Minecraft news. And that's really about it for today's special news. I'll go over all the other main stuff that we know for 1.7 for you guys to stay up to date. There's a new Skylands option, which is going to be kind of like super flat. Some people are calling it like floating cliffs, floating mountains, floating islands. I'm calling them Skylands because that's kind of what they are, and you know, that's what we all know them as. And next off, there is fishing, which I talked about. You can get like the fishing mechanics, the reels, it's all different. There's like over 15 different things you can catch, and there's different fish. We don't know if the fish are actual mobs that you can see in the water, but we know you can catch them at least. There are many new biomes, more than just the canyons, giant forest, and cliffs, which those are the three that have been confirmed. We still speculate that there possibly are volcanoes and a bunch of other type of biomes, but we do know that there are many new biomes, as stated multiple times by Jeb and the Mojang crew on their post. Posts and everything. And another awesome thing is altitude snow top. So for people that don't know what that means, is in certain biomes, if you build up at a certain height, it starts to snow. For example, on the cliffs biome, which is a new one, on the very top of the cliffs you can actually see snow, and snow will fall. In the desert biome, you're gonna have to build like 90 blocks high, but it'll start to snow up there. If you're in a jungle, maybe you build like 60 blocks high and it starts to snow there. And in a taiga forest, it snows pretty much everywhere. So that's the altitude differences. Also, there's flowers, and by flowers we mean sunflowers, little poppies, and of course, I think it's lavender flowers as well, and of course, 2-block-high grass. Oh, and the sunflowers always point towards the east, so we know that's coming out and it's been confirmed. There's also falling particles. When you hit the ground, there's gonna be awesome little particles all around you, as well as biomes now spawning next to other biomes that kind of fit each other's description. There's like 4 different categories, like ones that snow, ones that are cold, ones that are warm, ones that are like medium temperature. So if you're like in a medium temperature one, like a jungle, you might spawn next to, I don't know, a desert, or maybe, maybe a slightly cold biome. Whereas if you are in a taiga forest, which is like a winter biome, you're probably not going to be spawning that biome next to a desert biome. But it still happens. They even said it's just really rare now and just uncommon. And yeah, so that's about it for that. The few other things are pretty much just resource packs, which I talked about yesterday. Their menu has been updated. Of course, a bunch of little cool features like achievements, scoreboards, other server stuff that you guys probably won't remember after the update's release have been added. And yeah, that's about it for that. There's a couple other things I probably missed, but that was the main important stuff. So now you guys are up to date on everything in 1.7. I apologize for the fact that there was no snapshot today. I don't really have any control over it whatsoever, but if it makes you feel better, I'm sorry. And I will keep you guys up to date for any more snapshot news that happens and comes out. And yeah, that's about it for me, guys. If a snapshot does come out tomorrow or any other time, or we just get anything, I will make a video about it and inform you guys ASAP. So keep tuning in for that. That's about it for me, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'm SlayRocket86. Leave a like if you like the video, share this video with all your friends, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye.